alumni.
Hello. How's it going?
Hello, can you hear me? Well, yeah, perfect. Oh my God. That's a good mic.
My name is Juan. This is Julian.
Hello, nice to meet you all. And let's start with the Butterfly.js effect. It has been said that something as small as the flutter of a butterfly wing can ultimately cause a typhoon or hurricane halfway around the world. And this comes from the chaos theory. We want to show how can we use this effect to change a lot of lives.
We've come from far away to tell you a story. One we'd put under the magical realism genre 8 years ago. We wouldn't believe it if you told us.
Yeah, this is the story of how six individuals set off a community typhoon, how they established a huge change that they will never imagine.
This is six nerds with a lot of time on their hands.
A lot of time back in the days.
It all starts with a bridge between New York
and Colombia.
And Colombia. That led to the creation of a huge, huge tech community in Latin America. And it begins with the flap of a wing. First conference I ever organized was in 2011, called Bogota Conf. And it was born from the idea of having meetups. I was in New York, I was exposed to the local community, which is amazing. And I had made a lot of friends, and I wanted to share and bring that back to Colombia. So try to bring it back. This is Baby Juan organizing his first conference. Who you don't see in the screen is someone who you may know is Paul Irish. He's presenting on Skype to our first event. This conference was very magical because it led to the foundation of our first meetup ever, Bogota.js, which was founded a month after Bogota Conf, and it led me also to getting a new job where I met a few folks and we started CodeRise. What is CodeRise, Julian?
CodeRise was a program that we were teaching programming to underprivileged teenagers from 12 to 17 years old. It was a 9-week boot camp. We taught them HTML, CSS, and fundamentals of programming with JavaScript. And at the end, they needed to build a project and do like a pitch. And just by doing that small program, we have created a lot of leaders and potential leaders in the Colombian community.
The funny thing is that despite me not knowing Julian, he was the instructor. He became the instructor for CodeRise. And also Adrian, who is now an organizer of JSConf Colombia.
That started the beginning of Medellin.js. The next Bogota Conf in 2012, I decided to create the same model that was working in Bogota, Bogota.js, and I went there thanks to Juan Pablo. He invited me and gave me a scholarship to attend this conference for a second time, and I met the organizer of Bogota.js. I told him I want to do the same in Medellin, and he flew to Medellin the next year to open a new meetup, and that started a whole revolution.
So here in the far right, you see Julian, the audience of the first conference I ever organized. We had not met each other. That year, 2013, did anyone go to 2013 JSConf?
Amelia Island?
Union.
Woo! Hands.
So let's enhance. Let's enhance. That bald headache, Juan. And that was the day that I spoke to Chris Williams and convinced him to let me use the JSConf brand to Colombia. You know this guy too, right? It's Ryan. And the funny thing is he picked this talk anonymously. He didn't know that it was our talk, and he picked it on this time around. So it's pretty interesting. But that led to JSConf Colombia. It also led to
Yes, after the first years of Colombia, a lot of the different leaders or people interested in the different cities in Colombia decided to start working in their own meetups. We created a third one, Cali.js. Cali is the third main city of Colombia. And having these three main meetups, we decided to create something more bigger, and we created Colombia.js. Thanks, after the creation of Colombia.js, more other people from different cities raise hands and say, okay, I want to bring the same meetup to Pereira. I want to bring the same meetup to Bucaramanga. I want to same the brain to Manizales, Quibdo, Monteria, Valledupar, Popayan, and Barranquilla. So all of the main cities in Colombia following the same model and using our network and resources decided to start like a something that became way bigger than us. But this doesn't stop here.
That was 2015 and we had some money. So we talked to the Ruby folks and said, hey, let's launch a conference. Let's use some JavaScript money to launch a conference. So we did.
And also since JSConf and RubyConf were both international conference that you need to buy a ticket to get in, we decided to create PataConf. Now that we have a venue and we have the resources, why not create a conference for the Colombian community by the Colombian community, so all Colombian speakers had the opportunity to talk about any technology but JavaScript and Ruby. It wasn't fair. JavaScript and Ruby already had like two main conferences. And this conference, we created it, and it is free. Anybody can attend, and we always do it one day before the JSConf happens.
We wanted to transcend to cyberspace, so we created a virtual meetup as well. It's a Spanish meetup. We've been dragging our feet a little lately on it, but its intent is to share high-quality content to Spanish speakers who don't get access to it in general due to the lack of due to the language barriers.
And this started this whole Colombia Dev community. We put all of the different communities and different technologies together in one place. And we invited all of the leaders and most active members of these communities to start contributing, sharing tips, and start building the networks that created this amazing technology in Colombia and Latin America.
So we're not here to take credit, but to represent the work that hundreds of technology leaders in a country without a big infrastructure has led to build.
We have mirrored developer tech ecosystems like this one, despite having the proper infrastructure to run big conferences.
We've also kept diversity and inclusion in mind from day one.
And since we have learned a lot of things doing this, we started building a platform.
Today, the Colombian community is recognized worldwide. We got a shout out from the inventor of Pixin in their talk.
And thousands of Colombian programmers are learning connected to each other. They're creating this big network of knowledge.
So Julian, why is this so magical?
Okay, let's do an exercise and everybody please close your eyes. Close it completely.
I can't see your eyes, Jen.
Everybody, eyes closed, perfect. So, what is the first thing that comes to your mind when you hear the word Colombia? Keep that image in your mind. Don't judge it. Don't analyze it. Just keep it. Colombia.
You can now open your eyes.
Open your eyes.
And we are very aware that our not so fun history precedes us. Also, thank you, Netflix.
Yeah. But we are on a mission.
And we're on a mission to build a developer community that helps Colombia leave its past behind.
By exposing the local community to modern techniques, tools, processes, and all of the different technologies that empowers the open web right now.
We also want to highlight the effort of local community members who promote the growth of inclusive and respectful communities.
And generating social impact by making knowledge accessible to as many Colombians and Hispanic Americans as possible.
So how can you do the same?
Juan Pablo, tell us.
It all starts with a bridge that you're going to have to build. Much like Julian, when he jumped on a boat into city, remote city in Chocó to be the first speaker in a, at a remote event. So we come here to share some lessons. First of all, you need to use your privilege as a bridge to get speakers. One or two well-known speakers make all the difference when you're starting up. It's the only way that you can legitimize an event. You remember I mentioned Paul Irish was on the other side of this. Right. The fact that we could count with Paul on our landing page as one of the first speakers gave our event legitimacy, and it meant that people were interested in it. And the reason why we were able to do that is because we had a network. We already had some trust. So use that. Your speakers also become your ambassadors. You might know these nerds. We treat them well. We feed them, pay them all expenses, and make sure that when they leave, they're so happy they want to come back.
And I will bet those speakers or the ones that are here when they close their eyes and thought about Colombia, the image was totally different, for sure.
Also sponsors. Local sponsors, they love to partner with you, but you really can't pay hotels or flights or food with favors. Yeah, I'd love to have my logo and we're gonna be platinum, okay? Show me the cash. No, we can give you exposure. No, thank you. So ask for cash or have them pay for expenses directly. What we've done in the past is, hey, we had a company sponsor, Brendan Ike's flights directly. Just, we don't touch money. We make sure that other people get taken care of, and that is a good way to convince sponsors to give you that money. You can also find friends in big companies, and they'll so that they can help you sponsor for the love of art. Because your market, like your community, usually won't be marketable for any big company. A big problem in Latin America, a big challenge in Latin America, is that companies don't find us interesting as a talent pool or as a place to sell products. So sponsoring becomes less interesting. But if you have friends in big companies, or if you are a person that can give away some money, do it. We talk about money. It is very likely that you lose money in the first event.
And in the second.
And the third. So keep in mind that running a not-for-profit community does not mean you're running a charity, right? Take care of yourself. So build an operating budget that takes in mind your operations, how much you're paying for your email, your hosting, so anything, any expense, make sure that you can build it into that budget. If you want to see a real budget example, we've open sourced our 2013 budget. Beware, we lost money, but we recovered 2 years later. Leadership. Start with a small team. If you're starting to run a community in a conference, you don't want to learn how to manage people at the same time. This is our very small team. Once your event is sustainable, you can know a lot more people. This is the current organizer group for JSConf Colombia.
And it has grown. We have like three more people.
Now we have three more. But then make sure you give away your Legos. If you bring people in, you have to give them big problems and have them handle and teach them how to do things. If not, you won't be able to guarantee that your event will survive past you. Bridge a culture as well. We mentioned that we've always kept in mind building an inclusive and accessible and diverse community. Just make sure you can afford it, right? Giving away opportunity scholarships from day one when you can barely pay tickets, it's not smart. You want your event to last. So if you can't offer scholarships, it's not if, it's when. And iterating towards a better future is better than going broke. So what we've learned is, instead of giving food, like lunch, which is one of the most expensive things that you can have at an event, we make affordable tickets. And we make deals with restaurants that are close by, and we convince them to give discounts to our attendees. That's helped a lot. We also would much rather have live interpretation for English or Spanish speaking talks instead of a fancy party. Also, localized diversity, inclusion, and accessibility. Because did you know that 100% of people born in Colombia are Latin Americans?
Really?
Get the gist, right? The local context matters a lot. Draft a code of conduct, it's like your package JSON, and enforce it. When it comes to diversity, sponsorship is better than mentorship. So give a framework, give money, back off. Who has had an empanada in their life?
Eso.
This is my little empanada. Because I started something that I don't talk a lot about, but it's called an empanada fund. And if you're about to start a meetup anywhere in Latin America, you get 30 minutes office hours with me where I share the framework of how we started our meetups. And I also sponsor empanadas and beverages for your first event, as long as you send me a picture of it. I've helped start over 30 meetups in Latin America and hope to continue to do so. Starting and maintaining these communities is difficult. It's mostly unrecognized and
a fuck ton of work.
So let's hear it for the JSConf organizers, please.
Woo-hoo!
And if you can, and they want, give them a hug afterwards, please. You won't make money, and you will likely lose some. But you'll set up a chain of events that will be extremely rewarding. These two folks are currently my bosses. Steve and Matt are the founders of Splice, and they met at the speaker's dinner of the second conference I ever organized. This is when, right after they met, they started a company, and 4 years later, they hired me. They gave me a chance. You'll also make amazing friends. And your impact will go far and beyond.
Let's talk about that impact. So we have congregated, as I said before, the majority of community leaders and most active members in an invite-only Slack. Right now we have around or over 1,500 people registered, and we are looking forward of ways to open it more. It is invite-only because handling this amount of people initially is very difficult. We also created an index of the different Colombia tech meetups that are registered, and we found out that there is more than 50,000 people registering those meetups. You might want to take a look at the other page with all of the meetups that are in Colombia right now. We also, the event framework we have been building since the beginning has been successfully replicated by other events outside of the ones we have started. So we have inspired other people to create their own new conferences and their new meetups. Conference and meetups like ScaleConf Colombia, DinosaurJS here in the United States, and Hackdo, which is a conference that is being held in one of the most underprivileged regions in Colombia. There's a picture of Hackdo, and as you can see all of those butterflies in these people's heads, these people are community leaders that organize different meetups all around Colombia, and we got together, build the bridge, pay for our own flight tickets to go to this region that is far away from the major cities in Colombia, forgotten by the government. And we went there to create an amazing conference, and the community were spectacular and received what we were able to give in an amazing way. Right now, this group, Hakdo, is running a foundation, and they're teaching this job in Choco. They are creating the same bootcamp for free, so they are enabling more people to be able to access a better job and improve their lives. Also, a lot of other specialized communities had spread in all of the region. Pioneras Dev is one of those examples of a women community that started on a simple meetup. It was an old school, only for girls, that we created in Medellin. And right now, this community is huge and it's in different cities in Colombia, and they are organizing their own conference.
It's an example of where sponsorship is better than mentorship.
And people involved in this same group are part of other conferences, so it is the same network. Colombia has established as a tech hub, and it has become very attractive for companies abroad, and they are coming there, establishing companies, hiring people, and obviously the talent is growing, lives are being transformed, and we are becoming our own role models. One of our organizers, Juliana, started as, I don't know anything about programming, I want to learn in this small meetup, and this year she was giving a talk at O'Reilly Fluent Conf, so this is amazing. We have made friends from everywhere in the world and in Latin America, and we are happy to see here friends from Chile, friends from all the other parts of the world, so thank you very much for coming to this talk, and we have built this like friendship between all of the different communities in Latin America, looking forward to start building more of those bridges. We also ask our community about the impact in their lives. We wanted to know how they have been benefited by the community locally. There are some responses that we want to share. Meet Claudia. Claudia has been recipient of a scholarship for our conference. She has also given workshops and become a speaker. And one of the things she shared is that being a speaker when I started in this company allowed me to overcome the fears completely, fears imposed by working on a toxic culture and a toxic company. Meet Alejandra. Alejandra, also part of small communities, started organizing NG Conf and Node Conf. And for her, it's very exciting to see people donate their time because they want others to have the necessary expertise to succeed. And she felt inspired to continue that work. Other example, meet Samuel Burbano. He has been one of our most youngest speakers. When he was 16 years old, he got accepted to give a talk at JSConf Colombia. And thanks to that, he was able to build a huge network of contacts that started to define exactly the career path he wanted for life. Just by having 16 years old, he was starting to figure out what he wanted for life. And Laura, finally, she works with us at JSConf Colombia. She's one of the most amazing organizers. She's always eager to help. And she says that in a social context like Colombia, a community is a great opportunity for those who have or think they have limited life or career choices. Pioneras, the community she also founded, the women community in Medellin, certainly shaped my life in the most positive way. Without all the joint efforts of many people like Juliana and Juan Pablo, this story will have been different. So one small flap can make a lot of change. You can find all of the responses at impact.colombiadev.org if you want to take a look at other people, what they want to say. Our family keeps growing and growing. We are super happy about that. The Butterfly JX, the Butterfly JS effect becomes a cycle. People that were recipients of a scholarship, then they become speakers, then they grow and become organizers, then they create other communities. One beautiful example, Anna, she's in the middle with the butterfly in her head. She was a student at this CodeRise program back in 2012 when she was 14 years old. Then she was a recipient of a scholarship for different JSConf. And right now she's leading the sponsorship department at JSConf, and she's the one in charge of bringing all the money.
She's raised over 50K just this year by herself with her team.
And we have met the goal, which is amazing. So stronger wings with every new member. make more impactful typhoons or hurricanes. One beautiful example, not only happened in Colombia, we have other wings all around the world. We invited Mariko to speak at JSConf Colombia back in 2015. For certain reasons, Mariko didn't make it, and she decided to donate the scholarship. We gave the ticket to Claudia, one person from the community. Claudia was able to buy her own ticket for 2016, and she wanted to meet Mariko because she was interested in the technology, but Claudia didn't knew that Mariko donated her ticket. When we told that to her, beautiful thing and magical thing happened. I really encourage you and invite you to go and visit Mariko's blog post and see all the summary of the magic that happened in that special event. Thank you very much, Mariko. Thank you, Mariko. But we don't want to see this change only happening in Colombia. We want it in all Latin America. So you have also a lot of work to do. And here's where you can come in and help bring all of this movement to Latin America.
A few years ago, we think we had just launched RubyConf Colombia, and the dollar and peso were doing its thing, but suddenly something happened in the US and the Colombian economy went to hell, and people were not being able to afford the tickets that we were selling. So we launched a fundraising campaign for t-shirts.
This is where you
see this one. We're launching that again today.
Woo! Woo!
So if you want to get a t-shirt and become an ambassador,
or hoodie, or
you can go to support.colombiadev.org, and we have hoodies, tank tops, anything, and all the proceeds will go towards documenting the framework that we've built for events in developing nations, and hopefully growing and launching the Empanada Fund worldwide, or at least in Latin America, where we have empanadas, maybe a dumpling fund somewhere else. And this is exactly how you can use your privilege. Give us your money. But we've also had our butterflies. Does anyone know what jQuery was?
Old school.
So I used to be a chef, and when I was closing the kitchen, I would listen to podcasts, and I really liked programming a lot. I never saw me taking the career of programming ever at all. I learned HTML, CSS, because I had a band, MySpace, like as one does. And I was learning JavaScript, and I would listen to the jQuery podcast, and they started this. They set this off in motion. So if you see Paul or Rebecca or Adam or Alex, give them a hug.
I don't have any slide for my butterfly because I have him right next to me. Thank you, Juan Pablo, for inspiring me and allow me to do this. And thanks to Juan Pablo's mentorship, I was able to give my first international conference back in 2014. It was at JSConf in Uruguay. So everybody has its own butterfly. So you can become your own butterfly for your community and more people. Thank you very much.
Thank
Muchas
you.
Gracias. And if you want the shirt, go to supportcolombiadev.org and maybe help fund the next JSConf in Latin America. Thank you.